Hernig, your commentators Hugh Porter and Tony Gubber.
Rolf Golz of West Germany on the left, Mario Hernig of East Germany on the right. It's East against West Germany in this first semi-final in the amateur pursuit. Mario Hernig of East Germany, one of three East Germans who've come through to contest the semi-finals. They could make a clean sweep of the medals if this man gets through to the final. And already the riders completing the first circuit. And Golz is the quicker man, 26.63 for the first circuit here, ahead of Hernig by 0.71 of a second. There's Mario Hernig, rather Rolf Golz, who did that time of 4.44.94 during the eighth finals, which makes him the second fastest man we've seen in this amateur pursuit. Still ahead, now by 0.88 of a second.
And this is the pursuit that counts, because this isn't the one where you've got to still go for a time. You've just got to beat your man. And if you beat your man here, then you are in the final. And of course, this West German rider, he's been a very, very smooth pursuiter and probably the find of this series. I can't recall seeing him in any other World Series before this. We've got an indication of the time now. The first Madu station, and it's Golz, 1:11.96 for the first kilometre. So that's a very quick schedule indeed.
And the lead that he has remaining consistent, it was 0.7 of a second, 0.8, marginally up 0.9. But the two quickest times these men had turned in before put them only about a second and a half apart. And still Golz in the lead, now by just over a second. Rolf Golz coming round the finishing curve in front of the grandstand. We'll see the lap marker saying seven laps to go, 1:58.56, and increasing his lead now, 1.4 seconds.
And the East German there, Hernig, probably one of the most consistent of the pursuiters throughout this series. 2:4.45 to his credit, nice smooth style there, no wavering around at all. But the opposition from West Germany, also a stiff opposition, but Hernig also very strong indeed. Coming up to the stations, and it's Golz who's still in the lead. Golz from West Germany, the find of these series, following a very smooth line indeed there.
Well, it's amazing that this West German has been carving time off Mario Hernig of East Germany on every lap, now increasing his lead to 1.67 seconds. And back again in front of his original station. 2:45.29, and it's increased yet again, 1.97. So on every lap, the West German is overhauling the East German. That's really consistent riding.
Hernig, I don't think, can be discounted because of his consistency in the early rounds. As I said, 4:45 in both rounds, and he won his quarter-final this morning with 4:54. But the West German piling it on here, full of confidence now, really into his style.
And look at that, it's now over 2 seconds, the lead that Rolf Golz of West Germany has over Hernig of East Germany, and there are only just over three laps remaining in this first semi-final. Well, the East Germans have looked so invincible in so many of the events here in these World Championships, but this looks like a possible elimination for Hernig. 1.78, so for the very first time on that lap, the first time in this semi-final, the East German has gone round quicker than Golz, so he's beginning to overhaul him. Can he cut back the deficit?
And if he can cut the deficit back, he really is moving, because Golz went through the 3 kilometre mark in 3:32, which is a staggering speed. It means that at the moment they could run out with a 4:43 for the distance, and if they kept that up, it could break the track record.
Marginally improved again, but there's not much left. And as Rolf Golz comes round to the home station, that's Hernig on the far side. The bell signals one lap remaining, and let's see how big the lead is. 1.26 of a second. That's cut back again by Hernig of East Germany, but he's only got one lap left, and surely if this West German doesn't die over this final lap here, then he's going to get victory. The mouth's open, taking in as much air as possible, beginning to roll a little bit in the saddle, and the East Germans put in a marvellous last lap. Oh, but Golz got it, but so close, just over 0.3 of a second. Rolf Golz there of West Germany is the victor in that first semi-final. But what a marvellous ride it was. Hernig of East Germany was so far behind, almost 2.5 seconds behind at one stage, and he cut it back until the deficit at the end, well, it was...